Arizona's Fair Wages and Healthy Families Act goes into effect in little more than a week, and it means all businesses need to provide sick leave. But will that impact, and how will that impact small businesses? Does it matter if you only work a few hours a week? Well, these are some questions that we're asking here this morning. Labor and employment attorney Jessica Post, she is joining us here this morning with some answers this morning. So July 1st, this is a big date. First of all, some businesses have not been offering sick time, so now it's across the board.
Generally, that's correct. All employers need to start offering paid sick time as of July 1st if they weren't already doing so.
How does this work? Will it start accruing, or do you, on July 1st, I get 5 sick days?
Employers are choosing different options in terms of how they want to do it, but the accrual needs to be where employers are allowing employees to have at least 1 hour of paid sick leave for every 30 hours worked, up to either 40 hours for employers of 15 or larger in terms of employee size, or 24 hours if it's fewer than 15 employees.
And then we're dealing with some part-time employees, full-time employees. Are there different rules for both?
There's not different rules in terms of the accrual rates. Uh-huh. They have to meet those accrual rates, but you can have different policies in place for full-time versus part-time. So for example, like a full-time employee, you might say, well, you actually get 80 hours per year. Uh-huh. Part-time employees are going to be limited by what the act requires. So as long as you have a policy in place, you are allowed to treat different employee categories differently, so long as you're complying with the requirements of the act.
What type of industry will be impacted most by this? Many companies I've worked for have paid leave and paid sick time.
I do think small businesses, people with 15 or fewer employees, because they typically haven't been providing sort of paid sick leave. Part-time employees. So part-time employees, I think, were a segment of most companies' sort of employee group that didn't have time off because they were sort of presumed, hey, it's a part-time employee. They're now covered. Seasonal employees would be the same thing. So if a company hires somebody for 6 months and they're off for 6 months, they will still accrue that time and be able to use it, and it will carry over for that 6 months.
So will that paid sick time roll over from year to year?
So you have two options under the act. So employers can either choose to have it roll over, and the act requires up to 40 hours to roll over, or an employer can decide to pay it out at the end of the year. Yeah. So anything that was accrued but not used.
Get cash.
Yes, but if they do that, they have to then front load on the next day the full amount for the following year. So you would pay out the accrued, but then you would provide the 40 hours on January 1st, let's say if you were using a calendar year.
So we're talking about paid time off here. Can it only be used for sick time, or can we use it for a different reason?
Well, under the act, it can be used for different reasons. So even though we call it paid sick leave, it covers other things too. So it covers caring for a family member who has an illness, a doctor's appointment. It also covers health emergencies, which public health emergencies, which don't come up very often. But then also covers domestic violence and sexual assault and time off that would be needed to address those situations also. So it's actually broader than just the idea of an employee being sick who can't come to work.
So as an employee, come July 1st, what should we be aware of? What do you really want people to know?
Well, I do think that they need to be aware that the accrual starts, and they have to be prepared for that.
1 hour for every 30 worked.
1 hour for every 30 worked. In addition, they've got to be aware of the part-time and the seasonal employees. They should be aware that employees who start after July 1st, if they want, they can put a 90-day hold so that an employee starts accruing on that date, but they can't use it for 90 days.
Okay.
But that's only for employees who start after July 1st.
What happens if July 1st, I hear nothing from my company, and it doesn't seem like my company is going to start doing this?
Then if an employee is concerned about that, they should contact somebody in their HR department to find out, because companies right now, I certainly know from how busy I've been, companies are working hard right now to get themselves into compliance, and it may have happened and it has
slipped by, maybe something.
Yeah, although the act does require that employers are supposed to provide notice to employees of the provision of this act. Okay. So they should get this information.
And most companies are trying to do the right thing, but just beware. You know, you want to protect yourself and be aware of what's happening. And July 1st, you should start seeing something. That's great information. Thank you so much for being here. Appreciate it.
Yeah, no problem. Thank you.